and welcome my dear students. In earlier video, we have learned about modal verbs. Today, we are going to see finite and non-finite verbs. Now, let us understand the concept of finite verbs. So, let us see the definition. Finite verb is a verb that changes its form according to the tense of the sentence, number and person of the subject. Now the verb which changes according to the change in the tense, according to the change in the number and according to change in the person of a subject, that verb is called as finite verb. Let us understand with example. Now change according to tense. Now how the verb changes according to the tense. I love chocolates. Now this is simple present tense. The sentence is in simple present. See the second example, I loved chocolates. So now this verb love changed into loved. This is simple past. Next example, I am loving chocolates. So you can notice in these three examples that the verb love changed into loved and loving. So the verbs which change according to the change in the tense, these verbs are called as finite verbs. Okay? Now, second, change according to the number. Now, number, you know, that is singular and plural. Yes? So, when the subject changes its number, the verb also changes. For example, they play cricket. Now they is plural, isn't it? And he plays cricket. He is singular. So he is one, that is singular, and they is many, that is plural. So when the subject changes its number, the verb changes accordingly. So see here, you can see in this example, the verb play changed into plays when we change the subject they from plural to he in singular. Okay. For next example, mango is sweet. Now mango is a singular subject. So we have used the verb is. But if we use plural mangoes, then the verb is changes into are. Yes? So these verbs are called as finite verbs. Next is change according to person. Now person means what? Already you know that first person, second person and third person. So first person singular is I. Plural is we. Second person singular you, plural you. Third person singular he, she, it, and its plural is they. So when we change the person from first person to third person, then the verb changes. Now see here, we sing a song. Now we is first person, but if we change into she, that is third person, so she sings. So the verb sing changes into sings. So these verbs are called finite verbs. So how you will define finite verb? The verb that changes according to the tense, number and person of the subject, those verbs are called finite verbs. I hope you have understood what is finite verb. Now, let us see what are non-finite verbs. Non-finite verb is a verb that doesn't change according to the tense of the sentence, number or person of sentence. Now already we have seen that finite verb changes as per the tense of the sentence and as per the number and person of subject. But non-finite verbs doesn't change as per the change in the tense or as per change in the number or person of a subject. So these verbs are called as non-finite. Means they remain the same. There is no change in this verb. So let us see the example. I found his office at a walking distance. Tom will find his office at a walking distance. Now in these sentences, you can see that there are two verbs. So first, I found. Found is the verb. And walking. These are two verbs, right? In the second sentence, find and walking. Now you can see that in the first example, the verb found has changed to find in the second example. So this is which verb? Finite verb, because it changed its form according to the tense. Now I found his office at a walking distance, this is past tense, and Tom will find his office, it is future tense. So according to the tense, this verb changed. So these verbs are finite verbs. But see the verb walking, it did not change. It is same in the first example as well as in second example. So these are non-finite verbs. So the verbs which do not change according to the change in the tense or according to the change in the number or person of a subject, these are called as non-finite verbs. They remain unchanged. Okay. Now let us see the usage of non-finite verbs. Non-finite verbs can be used as a noun, as an adjective or as an adverb. So let us see the examples. The girl wants to read. Now, to read. The girl wants to read. Now here you can see the verb wants. This is finite verb because it will change if we change the tense. For example, the girl wanted to read. Or if I change the girls want to read. Yes. So if I change the number or tense, this verb changes. So this is finite. But to read will remain as it is. So this is a non-finite verb and it gives more information about the verb wants. So what she wants? To read. So this acts as an adverb. Next example, the sleeping dog is black. Now which dog? Sleeping dog. So sleeping here acts as an adjective. Sleeping acts as an adjective. See the third example, swimming is a good exercise. What is a good exercise? Swimming. So here the verb swimming acts as a noun. Okay. So non-finite verbs can act as a as an adverb, as an adjective or as a noun. I hope you have understood the concept finite and non-finite. Okay. Now, non-finite verbs are further divided into three types, that is infinitives, gerunds and participles. So this part we will see in our next video. Thank you.